reaction. See, your alcohol and aldehydes will be reduced to primary alcohol and secondary alcohol by means of sodium borohydrate and lithium aluminium hydrate. This is called as catalytic hydrogenation reaction, which we have seen in class 12, unit 11. Okay, I am repeating the first reduction. Your aldehyde will be reduced to alcohol. Similarly, your ketone, because both possess C double bond O group, so aldehydes and ketones will be reduced to, yes children, yeah, once again, your aldehyde and ketones will be reduced to primary alcohol and secondary alcohol respectively. Now, who is the catalyst here? The catalyst can be sodium borohydrate, that is NaBH4, or lithium aluminium hydrate, or it can be nickel, platinum, palladium or hydrogen. So these can be used as a catalyst. So I will be getting alcohol. Now look into the first reaction, HCHO. What is HCHO? It is formaldehyde. So formaldehyde is reduced to methanol. Look the number of carbon atom. In the reactant you have only one carbon atom. Similarly in the product you have one carbon atom, which is nothing but methanol. Now look into the second reaction. The second reaction is acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, acetyl group, that is methyl group is attached to aldehyde group. So this is acetaldehyde. When acetaldehyde is reduced, you will be getting ethanol, ethane OH. What is ethane? Carbon atom should be 2. Now I am going to replace with alcohol group. So C2H5OH, C2H5OH, this is nothing but ethanol. Now look into the ketones reaction, where my reactant is CH3COCH3. What is that? Two methyl groups are attached to ketone. So it is called as dimethyl ketone, or what is IUPAC name count? The number of carbon atom. The number of carbon atom is 3. Methane, ethane, propane. And I have to add the suffix O-N-E. So it is propanone. When propanone is reduced, what I will get? I will be getting CH3 twice CHOH. So 2 times C, it is nothing but methane, ethane. And there is one more carbon atom, 3. So it is propyl alcohol or propanol. Methane, ethane, propane, propanol or propyl alcohol. So this is the first way of reduction. Now I am moving to the second point. Your aldehydes and ketones can be reduced to hydrocarbon. So as the name indicates, there will be a carbon group and there will be a hydrogen group. No, this reduction is called as Clemmensen's reduction. Now who is going to catalyze this reaction? This reaction is catalyzed by zinc amalgam and a hydrochloric acid. Okay, clear. So I saw first reduction. The first reduction was aldehyde and ketone reduced to alcohol using sodium borohydrate and lithium aluminium hydrate. Done. Now second reduction is aldehydes and ketones can be reduced to hydrocarbons using sodium amalgam and HCl. This is called as Clemmensen's reaction. Now let me see that. See, C double bond O is reduced to CH2. What is CH2? Nothing but hydrocarbon. Now let us look into the reaction. I have same formaldehyde whose formula is HCHO. I have a normal aldehyde group to which if I attach an H, it is called as formaldehyde. Now formaldehyde is reduced to methane. Can you find out the number of carbon atom in the reactant and the product? In reactant I have 1C. In product I have 1C. So the number of carbon atom is maintained in the reactant as well as in the product. So when formaldehyde is reduced, I got methane. Now look into the second reaction. I have acetaldehyde. When acetaldehyde is reduced, I got again 2 carbon atom, which is same as that of reactant. This is called as ethane. Finish. Now what is third? Third is nothing but reaction of ketone. How my ketone is reduced to hydrocarbon? Here I have dimethyl ketone, otherwise called as propanone, which is reduced to, look into the number of carbon atom, 1, 2, 3. So it is propane. So what happened? My propanone is reduced to propane. Finished. So we have seen 2 reduction reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Let us move into the third reaction, which is called as Wolff-Kirchner reduction. In Wolff-Kirchner reduction also, your aldehydes and ketones are reduced to hydrocarbon, but only difference, in Clemmensen's reduction we used sodium amalgam and HCl, but in Wolff-Kirchner reaction we will be using hydrazine and potassium hydroxide. Okay, we will be using hydrazine. What is the formula for hydrazine? It is NH2NH2 along with the potassium hydroxide. So I will be getting alkanes. Now let me show you the reduction of ketones. In reduction of ketones, I am using red phosphorus along with the hydrogen iodide. I will be getting ketones. So we have seen four reactions under reduction of aldehydes and ketones. So what happens to aldehydes and ketones upon reduction? They will be reduced to primary and secondary alcohol. Aldehyde reduced to alcohol. Ketone reduced to alcohol. These reactions are catalyzed by sodium borohydrate and lithium aluminium hydrate. Okay. Now, your aldehyde and ketone can be reduced to hydrocarbons. Say for example, formaldehyde reduced to methane. Acetaldehyde reduced to ethane. Dimethyl ketone reduced to propane. So these reactions are called as Clemmensen's reaction. Why? Because they are catalyzed by sodium amalgam and HCl. Next, Wolff-Kirchner reduction. Here also your aldehyde and ketones will be reduced to hydrocarbons, but here you have the catalyst hydrazine and KOH, and we have reduction of aldehyde and ketone again to hydrocarbon with red phosphorus and hydrogen iodide finish. So we have seen reduction reaction, we have seen oxidation too. Next is reaction due to alpha hydrogen. Reaction due to alpha hydrogen. Let me now clear what is that alpha hydrogen. Whenever you have a functional group, say for example alcohol group or ketone group, or you have amide group, the numbering of carbon atom happens in such a way such that if my functional group, okay, the carbon next to the functional group is called as alpha group, and the carbon next to alpha is beta, and the carbon which is next to beta is gamma, and the carbon which is next to gamma is delta. So I can tell you these are Greek letters, that is your alpha, beta, gamma, delta. These are Greek letters. They are designated for carbon atoms which are located next to the functional group. Okay. So since your aldehyde and ketones, they have alpha hydrogen, means what? The hydrogen which is attached to the functional group of aldehyde and ketone, I am going to call that hydrogen as alpha hydrogen. Okay. Now what is the role of this alpha hydrogen? These alpha hydrogen of aldehydes and ketones are acidic in nature. So because of acidity, the carbonyl compounds have strong electron withdrawing group. So I am going to condense aldol. Okay. So what is my point now? I am going to do condensation of aldol. So we know that aldehyde and ketone are possessing an alpha hydrogen group. Okay. Now when I look into the first reaction, look into the reaction which is exactly the same. This is the picture from the textbook. Now I have ethanol. Why I am calling it as ethanol? Because the number of carbon atom is 2 and the functional group is aldehyde. So I am going to call this as ethanol. Ethanol in the presence of dilute sodium hydroxide, I got aldol. What I got? I got aldol. Now can I name this aldol? See, in the position 3, how should I number? I number aldehyde as 1. Second carbon atom should be numbered 2. The next one should be numbered 3. In the third position, there is a presence of hydroxy group. So I have written 3-hydroxy. Now let me count the number of carbon atom. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon atom. Methane, ethane, propane, butane. and it is an aldehyde group, so I have to add a suffix butanal. So what is the structure called? 3-hydroxybutanal, which is nothing but an aldol. Now I am heating this aldol. So what happens? There is a removal of water molecule and I have got an aldol condensation product, which is nothing but butenal. This is a condensation product done. Now the same thing we are going to see for propanone. Okay, exactly the same picture from the textbook. Propanone, what is the other name for propanone? Dimethyl ketone, because I have two methyl groups, CH3 CH3, two methyl group, and the central I have a keto group, so this is called as dimethyl ketone, whose IUPAC name is propanone. Now here I have added the base barium hydroxide. So what is the product formed? The product formed is called as ketole. Now let me name this ketole. Now count the number of carbon atoms. I mean, see the functional group, where the functional group is present, and accordingly number them. In the fourth position, I have got hydroxy group, as well as in the other side, I have got a methyl group. So I have to name this as 4-hydroxy-4-methyl. In the fourth position, I have both OH group as well as methyl group. So I am going to name them as 4-hydroxy-4-methyl. Now count the number of carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane. And since it is ketone, I have to add the suffix O-N-E. So this structure is called as 4-hydroxy-4-methylpentanone, which upon heating with the liberation of water, I will be getting an aldol condensation product. I can name this too, because in fourth position I have methyl group. When I count the number of carbon atom, it is pentane. There is a presence of double bond, so I am mentioning it. In third position I have EN. In the second position I have ketone group, so I have expressed ONE. If you feel to write this aldol condensation product's name, you can leave it and simply write that as aldol condensation product. That's it. So till now what we saw? We saw the reaction of alpha hydrogen. Alpha hydrogen is present in both aldehyde and ketone. It is acidic in nature. So they are reacting with alkali. What was the alkali which was used in aldol condensation? For aldehyde we used sodium hydroxide, and for ketone we used barium hydroxide. We got an aldol condensation product. Okay, so upon reaction of aldehyde and ketone with alkali, we got aldol and ketol respectively. This is called as aldol reaction. So the name aldol is a mixture of aldehyde and alcohol group, correct? No, it is a mixture of aldehyde and ketone group. Aldol, ALD refers to aldehyde group, OL refers to alcohol group. Now these aldols and ketols can lose water to give me an unsaturated carbonyl product. This is nothing but aldol condensation product, hence the reaction is called as aldol condensation. What happens to ketone group? Ketone group will be giving ketols. Ketol is a mixture of ketone group and alcohol group. Can you name it? KET means ketone group. OL means alcohol group. Now this also upon heating liberates water, resulting in aldol condensation product. So we know about aldol condensation as well as ketol condensation. Okay, so aldol condensation from aldehyde as well as from ketone was clear. So what happens? Let me do a quick recap. Aldehyde, I have to take an aldehyde. Since the alpha hydrogen of aldehyde is acidic, I am treating it with as alkali, which is nothing but sodium hydroxide. I will be getting an aldol, which liberates water to give me aldol condensation product. Aldol means mixture of aldehyde and alcohol. And similarly, ketone reacts with a base to give you ketol, which upon releases water, there is a liberation of water molecule, resulting in aldol condensation product. Why the name is ketol? Because it's a mixture of ketone and alcohol group. Till now we saw aldol condensation. So next we are moving to cross aldol condensation. Okay, so what is cross aldol condensation? When I am going to carry out aldol condensation between two different aldehydes or two different ketones, I am going to call them as cross aldol condensation. So let me repeat, what is cross aldol condensation? When condensation reaction is carried out between two different aldehydes and two different ketones, then the reaction is called as cross aldol condensation, and I will be getting a mixture of four products. So how many products I will get? I will get a mixture of four products. Now this is also the picture exactly from the textbook. Let me tell you the reaction for cross aldol condensation. I have acetaldehyde and I have ethanaldehyde. Let me repeat, what is the first compound? CH3CHO, acetaldehyde. Then look into the second, two carbon atom along with aldehyde, methane, so it is ethanaldehyde. When methanaldehyde and acetaldehyde reacts, I will be getting a product called butenal. Now see how I have divided this two. I have divided this two in such a way. Look into the first one. This is simple aldol condensation product, or I can tell self aldol. They have done a selfing among themselves, and I have got simple aldol condensation products, which is otherwise called as self aldol products. Let me tell you the product name. Look into the number of carbon atom. 1, 2, 3. I have an aldehyde group and I have an OH group. So what is this called, children? This is an double bond containing compound along with an aldehyde containing and OH containing products. Now I have got two more products extra. They are called as cross aldol condensation. So as the name indicate, when I cross two type of aldehydes, that is acetaldehyde and ethanaldehyde, upon heating with the sodium hydroxide, I will be getting self aldol and cross aldol condensation product. Okay, now let me tell you clearly, look into the textbook reaction. You have acetaldehyde, you have ethanaldehyde, you have heated with NaOH, you got the double bond containing product as butenal. I have indicated two because in the second position I have got double bond. This is butenal, and I have got the second self aldol product as 2-methyl 5 carbon atom. So it is 2-methyl pent. In the second position double bond is there, so 2-methyl pent-2-enal. Why I have written AL in all these products? Because we have the functional group aldehyde. Now let us look into the cross aldol condensation product, where I have got pent-2-enal. Count the number of carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is pent. In the second position there is double bond, so 2-ene-AL is aldehyde. Clear? Now look into the fourth product, count the number of carbon atom and just see the attachment here. In the second position I have methyl group, so 2-methyl butane, second position double bond, so butene, since the aldehyde group is a functional group AL, 2-methyl butenal. Okay, so this is nothing but your aldol condensation reaction. In this we have seen self aldol condensation as well as cross aldol condensation. Let me tell you what is Cannizzaro reaction. With this the chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones will be finished. So what is Cannizzaro reaction? See, aldehydes which do not have alpha hydrogen atom, there are some aldehydes, they don't have alpha hydrogen atom. So what they will do? They will only do self oxidation and reduction reaction when I heat it with the concentrated alkalis, where one molecule of aldehyde is reduced to alcohol while other will be oxidized to carboxylic acid salt. Let me repeat, aldehydes which do not have
alpha hydrogen atom will undergo self-oxidation and reduction. One aldehyde is reduced to alcohol while other aldehyde is oxidized to carboxylic acid salt. Let me tell you the reaction, exact picture from the textbook. I have formaldehyde. Then I have second molecule, that is CH2. See, formaldehyde, when it is reacting with the concentrated alkali, that is KOH, what is the product form? I got methanol, which is a primary alcohol, and carboxylic acid salt, which is nothing but potassium formate. Look into the second reaction. I have a benzene ring. To the benzene ring, aldehyde group is attached. So this is called as benzaldehyde. When I heat it with concentrated NaOH, what I got? I got benzyl alcohol plus sodium benzoate. So I have got a carboxylic acid salt and I have got an alcohol. Okay, and I have got an alcohol. And electrophilic substitution, where your aldehyde and keto groups are meta-directing groups, means what? Only in the meta positions my substituents will be added. First reaction is benzaldehyde, because benzene and CHO, I am adding nitric acid. So what will I get? I got meta-nitrobenzaldehyde. Finish. Now look into the second reaction, that is your halogenation, where I am adding chlorine group along with the catalyst aluminium chloride. So where did the attachment happen? In the meta position. So it is metachlorobenzaldehyde. Finish. What is the next reaction? It is sulfonation. So I have to add a sulfuric acid group along with the oleum as a catalyst. Here the sulfonic acid group will go and attach to which position? Meta position. So what it is called? Metaformyl benzene sulfonic acid. So in all these positions there is an attachment of substituent group in the meta position. Okay, yeah, thank you children.